guys， 欢迎大家继续收看美国谚语 idioms。我是 Champ America 强探美国职业规划师事务所的 Heather 吕薇老师，和我在一起的呢是我们的英语口音教练 Be Understood 创始人 Linda Nelson 老师。
Hi， and I'm Linda. I'm a certified speech language pathologist and speech coach at Be Understood. I wanted to explain that idioms are used in every language, but are frequently used in English.They're a group of words or phrase that has a figurative meaning. It's not easily understood from its literal definition. Today, we're going to continue to talk about idioms, especially those that are related to work, work style, and projects. What I did want to mention is that we don't use idioms back to back or in a row or consistently in a sentence or in conversation.We use them intermittently to sound natural. What Heather and I are going to do today is string a bunch of idioms together. So it might sound very awkward, but we're going to explain them at the end, and then you will hear them, learn to listen for them, and then be able to put some into your conversation.
Bottom line, 我们给大家做的只是一个演示。那么在实际生活当中呢，我们希望大家能够通过这个来理解这些谚语是什么意思，而不是一个接一个的在真正的日常对话中去用。Okay, are you ready, Linda?
I am.
Linda, I just hired a new employee. You should meet her. She's a real people person.
Heather, I thought you were putting that off until next year.
I have so much on my plate, Linda, so I pulled the plug.
I'm glad you didn't put it on the back burner, as business is really ramping up.
I love her. She thinks outside the box. I can't wait for you to meet her. I know you will see eye to eye and we'll be on the same page with her. And I'm confident that we'll be able to move the ball forward with our collaboration and projects.
I look forward to it.
Okay. Like Linda said, there's a lot of idioms that we just used.This is all about working hard and work style. So let us explain to you what all of these mean. First, I said I hired a new employee. She's a real people person. That means she's great with social skills, very outgoing.
And when I talked about I thought you were putting something off, that was to say that I thought you were going to delay something, put it off till later.
So we always say that we have a lot on our plate. It doesn't mean physically a lot of food on our plate, but it just means so much to do. So for those of you who are in school right now, between your coursework, organizations, and job search, you can really say, I have a lot on my plate and I'm busy.
When I use the phrase on the back burner, think about what a stove is like. The things that you are not actively working on, you put them on the back burner.You let them simmer quietly. So this explained as something less important. As business is really ramping up, I meant her business was really increasing.
So then I said she thinks outside the box. That is something you hear a lot, right? You might have used it in interviews as well. This is to say that this person is a creative problem solver. And see eye to eye and be on the same page both means agreeingor having the same approach or goal with somebody.
And moving the ball forward, it's actually a sports term, but it's used to show progress and growth.
好的，就像 Linda 老师刚才说的，这些谚语呢，我们是希望大家能够理解它的意义，并且能够在实际生活当中应用。但是呢，一定要记住，不要在一句话或者是一个 conversation 里面用太多的谚语。好，谢谢大家。